ask you in the community tab if you would like to see this video, and you all said yes, or a lot of people said yes. Sorry, that's the coffee. And yes, so let's start with one solution, and that's getting your list, the list of all the things that you can't do. Might know, I went to the studio, I had a very intense recording session, it was really cool. And then afterwards, of course, I have to listen to the tracks, and I really try to just really listen and not be so judgmental over myself, about myself, because I know there's certain things that are my weaknesses. And then I, for example, I'm always afraid that my timing won't be good, or that I'm getting faster, or yes, especially rhythmical things kind of freak me out. So if I'm listening to my recording, I'm only thinking about the time, if the timing is good, but I really try to understand that there's so many aspects that go into making music, and that I can also hear the rest of the things that are going on. One thing that I sometimes do is kind of a rhythmic displacement, but then I can't resolve it apparently. Then also my lines could be longer. I am playing a lot of 8 notes. I would really love to play more triplets and 16 notes. One thing that I really want to work is playing chords in between lines. I mean, I know how to play a chord in between a line, I guess, but sometimes the rhythmic placement is really not the best. To the fun part is like inventing exercises. Try to develop some exercises that you can work on. You know, like for example, rhythmic displacement is just like write down a rhythmic displacement and practice it in the most simple way. And then while you're practicing, you can develop exercises. But you need to start playing it, and then ideas will come. So if you want I could also make a video about developing your own exercises. That's always a lot of fun. Another thing that is really a good idea is to establish a system where you can either write down in a book or bookmark on your smartphone all the things that you encounter in the internet, in the YouTube videos, in books that actually inspire you and that you want to learn. Because I think big part is, of course, it's very easy to be overwhelmed. There's so much stuff out there, and if you skip the things that you're practicing every second day, then it's really hard to get a result. But if you maybe keep a book and just really write down what interests you, maybe that can help to stick with a thing, because then at least I wouldn't be so afraid to forget about it. And if we write down what we like or what we would like to practice, then we know it's in a safe space. So create a safe space for the things you want to practice, and then come back to it later. And another really cool thing that you can do is to meet with a friend, right? And just like meet and jam, but also, you know, like meet with a friend and then download lead sheets from Kurt Rosenwinkel or from whomever you want to check out the music, and then just play the music together and try to play the songs and just like discover music together. An exercise that I used to do with my guitar colleagues is so back to back, so you can't see the other person, and one person is playing a chord and the other has to improvise. Not so much saying the name and what are the notes in it, but just like hearing the sound and improvise over it. That's a great exercise. And also, if you're meeting with another person, chances are you are going to be very motivated afterwards. Just play a little bit, and also helps in realizing the spots that you have to work on. And yes, write them on your list, make a list, and make a detailed list, not too broad like I suck, but more like my 8 notes could be better if I'm playing at 128 beats per minute on a bossa nova, you know. So I think we all have that moment where we think everything we play is not great, and either we're bored to death by those phrases we have been playing over and over again, or we're just like don't know what to play anymore. And there I would also suggest get a new piece of music, can be something modern, can be a download from the internet. I'm going to list some websites where you can find great lead sheets and just check it out, like, you know, like a child, like, how does it work? Not with the goal of playing it perfectly, but just to know something else. And I think sometimes if we are playing, let's say, all the things you are over and over again, then that can be frustrating as well. And I also think that we reach this moment of diminishing returns, because it's like, you know, polishing a thing a lot of times is great, but sometimes going away, doing something else, coming back to it, so you have a fresh view, you keep it fresh, that can help to learn that as well.